here with Mr. Sese. And Mr. Sese is the term they use here is the head teacher. Or in America, we call it the principal. But he's the head teacher of a school in the Gambia. And he was talking about something I wanted to share with all of you, and that is how he used an unconventional technique to teach children. Can you elaborate on that, Mr. Sese?
When I first moved to the town, I was living around the corner of the town.
We're not going to say the exact town, but it's in the Gambia.
In Gunjo, in the Gambia. But Gunjo is a big town. But I don't live exactly inside Gunjo, but at the Askia part, around the edge of the But the school is at the center of Gunjo. So, but where my compound is far from the school that time. And students, kids, were just moving about, loitering, they are not going to school because they are far from getting access to the school. Community where people come from different parts in search of home, land to settle down with their families. So some are even foreigners from other countries, Senegal, neighboring countries, some from Mali, some from. So when your people help them with piece of land, where to settle down with their family. So, but their children are not having any access to the school. And they were not going to school because the place is far from the school. And they just keep on roaming. So me transferring to that place newly, and I'm the only educated person at that place, I feel like putting these children together so that they have the basic education. So I sacrificed one of my room to make it a classroom where I put bricks. There was no chairs, so they sit on. So I brought one blackboard from the school, put it there just to assist, to help them out, to get basic education, rather than just moving about, doing nothing as children. So I was doing that in the classroom, in one of my houses. I was doing that at the corner of the village. Until some people, passerby from Europe, found me there. So they were curious, and it was interesting to them. They asked me, what are you doing here? I said, well, here, it's far from the school, and the student, the village, the children are not going to school. They are just running about, and they are not educated. So I sacrificed my time to organize a blackboard to teach them elementary English, basically, language, English, and so that they can get educated. So they said, yes, we are also on trying to search for the same help around this area of the village. Because we realize that children around here are not going to school. They are far from the school. I say, exactly, that's why I'm sacrificing my time to help them out. So after school, after my working hours, I will arrange them, set them, and also I'll teach them. So they said, then we have the same opinion. Can we join and make it one? I said, yes, it's fine. I said, okay. They said to me, Next time when we come, we'll provide chair for you. But for this lot of children sitting on the bricks, empty floor and empty bricks. I said, really? They said, yes. I said, okay. I'm very pleased. By then, I don't have confidence in them. I thought they were just trying to make a joke. But on the whole, they were serious about it. And that the following next 3 weeks, they came again. They came with some chairs. I said, wow. I said, wow. Then we took out those bricks to sit on. Uh-huh. And then we are sitting on the floor. Now we have chairs. We started with that. So I continue to teach them. I continue to teach them. This impressed them very well. Continue to teach them. Until students, we are many. And in the evening, from 6 o'clock, from after work, the elderly people, I'll take them for elderly class. Because the parents also don't go to school. They don't know figures. So I'll teach the elders also at night, lighting candle, because there was no electricity. They light candle, and I teach their parents also. They were very happy. So during the day, I teach these children. At night, their parents. So that's how it was. So this thing grow. When it grow, it get grow. So these partners who join me, they find it necessary for us to have a school.